Okay, I wanted to talk about one more thing about introducing students to using their voice. And this isn't just singing, this is several different types of using our voice. But this is a really important part of them understanding how the vocal system works. And it's also a good way to introduce dynamics, how loud or soft the sounds are. So when you start working with children, and this is probably the first thing you need to do before you do a lot of singing, help them understand differences between what they can do with their voice. So I have a few examples up here, whispering, chanting, singing, and yelling. I could also add to that humming, which is kind of a whispered singing. But children need to know about the differences with these. And obviously they've used all these before somewhere in their life, but a lot of times they don't understand the differences in the sound quality and other things. So with young children, obviously it's really easy to say, okay, we're all going to whisper. Everybody whisper, repeat after me. My name is, and say your name. Do some whispering things, go back and forth. You could even do a portion of the class, maybe 5 minutes of the class, where everything you say as a teacher and everything that they respond as students is all done by whispering. And they're not used to doing that. They like to use their full voice. And so using whispers is a little strange at the first, but they get used to it and find it kind of fun to use different voice qualities. The next one I have up here is chant. I want you to go to lunch. Very rhythmic talking, which is what chanting is. And obviously we use chanting in music some, and it's a good way to give directions. It's a good way to have them respond because they're thinking more about rhythmic variety and things of that nature. And they're using their voice in a different way. So chanting is another good way to introduce their voice. And the next one we have is singing. So what's the difference between I am going to chant right now and I am going to chant right or sing right now? What's the difference between those two? Try and have them understand that when I chant, I'm just using short bursts of air, and when I sing, the air is constant, it's continuous, and it doesn't stop. And that produces a nice, beautiful singing voice, as opposed to chanting, which has short bursts of air. So you can see a big difference there. And again, mix and match, and they love to do these different things and understand how their voice works. And then the last one is yelling. And the big reason we have to introduce this one is because a lot of times you'll go to a children's music performance and you'll have a bunch of kids singing, deck the halls with boughs of holly, and then there's always one or two, deck the halls with boughs of holly, and they're just yelling instead of singing. And there's a difference. You know, there is such a thing as singing loud and singing soft, but a lot of times children will get into that yelling and it's really hard on their voice. Especially young vocal cords can be damaged quite severely if they sing too loud, if they yell when they're trying to sing. So make sure that they know the difference between yelling and singing loud. And this is a good way to help them with that, understanding those differences. So take different parts of your class and have them do all of these things for a certain amount of time. Obviously with the yelling, just do that maybe a few words and then stop. Make sure the door is closed so we don't cause too much racket around. But they need to know the differences between those things to understand their voice. And they need to know that some things are prettier than others. Singing sounds lots better than yelling. And I think singing sounds better than chanting. There's a purpose for both of those, but obviously one is going to sound better in a performance than another. So there's some more additional information about teaching children how to use their voice. And